Hi little skeletons, it is Disney Queen Skelly here. Welcome back to another Disney Media Review. So today we are reviewing the Disney short Babes in the Woods. It's a Silly Symphony cartoon. So how my reviews work is I read some stuff from IMDb to kind of give you a basis of what the short or movie or whatever I'm reviewing is. And then I kind of give you my own rating plus a couple of details that I either liked or didn't like from the movie, and yeah, we're just gonna do it like that. Okay, so here is what I found on Babes in the Woods before I actually watched the short. IMDb rating 6.5 out of 10 stars. Running time 8 minutes. Plot summary. Two Dutch children stumble upon a clearing in the woods where gnomes are going about their business. The gnomes are friendly to the children. A witch comes and takes them away on her broom to her gingerbread house where she turns nasty on them, turning the boy into a spider, her yowling cat to a stone, and tries to turn the girl into a rat when a gnome's arrow stops her. While the gnomes are fighting the witch, Hansel and Gretel free the other children who have been imprisoned and transformed by the witch. So I gave this short 6 out of 10 skulls. It wasn't exactly my favorite short. It didn't really capture my attention as much as some of the other ones did. And, you know, not to say that I only like the ones I do because of nostalgia, but I mean, I had never seen Santa's Workshop before, and that got one of my highest ratings here on Disney Media Reviews. But here's some of the reasons why I maybe did and didn't like Babes in the Woods. So, there was great singing and harmonies. I really liked that. You know, when it comes to the Silly Symphonies, Disney really knows what they're doing in terms of, like, who they get and to sing for them and who, like, you know, what they do in order to make all the music possible. The scary forest that the kids are running through reminds me of Snow White. Like, how the trees and, like, all the animals look really scary. Like, they look just so menacing, and then they turn out to be, you know, just sweet and beautiful and, you know, just all around nice. The gnomes looked like the elves from Santa's Workshop. I thought that was kind of cute, actually. They remind me of the dwarves with how they act, kind of like how the elves did in Santa's Workshop. These gnomes remind me of them, too. Specifically, how they clean, how they treat the kids, and how they play, like, instruments and sing. It definitely reminded me of the dwarves from Snow White. So I'm thinking maybe, like, Disney took some inspiration from, like, these shorts to make the dwarves from Snow White. But when the witch came, it was funny because she's flying down, right? So all the gnomes are like, oh no, the witch, the witch. So they're all running in their houses, and the one gnome's like, oh shit, can't forget my beer. And he grabs his beer and goes back inside. It kind of reminds me of Jurassic World, how like everyone was running away and the two guys, and like the guy was focused on like the two margaritas. At the gingerbread house, it didn't look like, I know this was the 30s, but that, or the 20s, 30s, early decade. Early 1900s. That gingerbread house did not look like it was well kept. It looked like it was melting. I don't know if it was just the animation, but the gingerbread house itself looked like it was melting. And I'm thinking, if you're gonna make something look appetizing to kids, the least you could probably do is make it not look melty. Like, the frosting looked like it had sat there for days. It was so disgusting. Oh, one of my favorite lines. Sugar, spice, and everything nice. That's what children are made of. It definitely reminded me of Powerpuff Girls. So I was like, oh, that's so cool. Sugar, spice, everything nice. She did have a lot of the kids turned into spiders, especially Hansel, which was, I mean, I love spiders, so kind of seeing that was cute, but I still felt bad for the kids. Yeah, the poor kitty got turned to stone. Like, I have a huge thing when it comes to animals and kids. Like, if I see a kid or an animal get hurt in a movie or done something to, I get sad. And I saw that poor cat get turned into stone, and he looked so sad. Made me sad. So the gnomes and the witches' final battle kind of remind me of the seven dwarves and the evil queen's battle from Snow White. A lot of this is reminding me of Snow White for some reason. But yeah, their final battle really reminded me of the final battle in Snow White and the seven dwarves, which was really cool. So I was like, that looks like that. That looks like that. I was just getting happy watching that bit. It was an interesting retelling of Hansel and Gretel. I know the original story, you know, not the original, because I think there might be a darker version than what we were told as kids, but I don't know that version. The version I know is Hansel and Gretel went to, like, left breadcrumbs to get themselves back home, and they got to the witch's cottage, and, you know, they almost got ate. stuff like that. But this is definitely a more interesting retelling, just because they added the gnomes in there. And not only that, but, like, the way they defeated the witch was really cool, too. But, yeah, I mean, it wasn't exactly my favorite short that I have watched so far. I personally didn't like it too much, but, I mean, some parts were really good. Some parts were really, really good. Just, unfortunately, it didn't grab my attention like a lot of the other shorts did. So, we'll see what happens next time I do a media review, guys. So, thank y'all so much for watching. I do encourage you to watch the short for yourself if you have Disney Plus, or if not, I think some of them actually might be on YouTube. But other than that, I thank y'all so much for watching. Bye, little skeletons. Stay safe. I love you guys.